course, got to punch it. Pretty good from an acceleration standpoint.
Hey everyone, it's Ben Hardy here, and in today's video, we're going over a 2022 GMC Sierra 1500 SLT with the X31 package. First and foremost, though, a huge shout out and thank you to National GMC for giving me some time with this truck. Check out their inventory link below. Let's get into the video. So under the hood, we have a naturally aspirated 6.2 liter V8 that goes through a 10-speed automatic transmission. Fuel economy is 14 around town and then 19 on the highway, with power outputs being 420 horsepower and then 460 pound-feet of torque. Now let's go over the front end of this SLT. So first off, we have the signature GMC hood here on the top, and the red really shows the body lines. And then I love this portion right here, kind of makes it look a little bit more aggressive. Got the C-shaped LEDs here with the reflector lights, got the fog lights just down below, parking sensors integrated here into the chrome front bumper. Notice the grille's also finished in chrome, got the GMC logo there in the center. Tow hooks on either side right there, and well, that's the front end. Now, coming around the side here, I've got two 75 millimeter tires wrapped around 20 inch wheels in the front and over in the rear as well. And you guys can see, again, they went for a chrome design with the wheels, which makes sense because the bumpers and the side steps and the mirrors. But anyways, notice that we have these aggressive all-terrain tires, and then you guys can see the front suspension a little bit. We have the blacked out fender flare, got the 6.2 V8 badge. Again, we got the contrast with the chrome, then the blacked out element just down below. Got our Sierra badge right there, chrome door handles, and then the chrome trim around the window. And then you guys can see everything here with the side steps. And then taking a few steps back, here's our full side view with the truck. And then moving on from that, I just wanna quickly show you guys here with the rear. Notice how there's a wheelhouse liner, which is definitely nice. You see the leaf springs a little bit. And then we got our X31 off-road sticker badge, not sticker. I don't know what I'm saying, guys. It's a badge. Anyways, let's continue on. Now here's our key fob. We got the unlock, the lock, the remote start, and then the drop down for the tailgate. We have a payload capacity of 1485 pounds, which a little bit of that is being used up by these boxes, and a towing capacity of 8,900 pounds. And aside from that, notice this one has the little handle that helps out with getting in. You've got the LED light here on that side. On the other side, notice how we have the power outlet. Got the GMC logo right there in the center. And this one has the cool tailgate. So, obviously it has the whole step system, which is pretty cool. It's cool to see the contrast of the red. Max weight on this is 375 pounds. So if your name is Thor Bjornsson, you probably can't use this tailgate. But if you're a normal human being, then you definitely can step up on this tailgate. But anyways, that's all for that. Now here's everything in the rear of the truck. Notice we have the GMC logo, the Sierra badge down below, and then the SLT logo. Got the C-shaped LED lights. We've got the bumper steps right here, parking sensors on the rear, the receiver hitch, and then the squished exhaust tips there at the bottom. And yeah, that's all for the rear. Now here's the door panel in the back. Notice how we have the padding here with the stitching, and then just down below, we've got the wood trim right there. And then we have our tubular door handle. One of the speakers for the sound system. And then here are the seats in the back. So you got the leather with the perforated leather here in the center portion. You got the little seat cubbies, which this one, there we go, didn't want to pull out for some reason. And then just down below, you can see that continuation of the perforated leather. And then the under seat storage, rubber floor mats in the truck. Got some cup holders right here. And then notice down below, you got the USBs and the 12 volt and some vents. And then this pulls down to actually be some more cup holders, which is definitely a nice thing to have. And well, that's all for the rear. Side steps, they also go to the bed, so helps out with getting into the bed. Pretty cool. Now here's the door panel at the front. So again, you've got that continuation with the padding, the leather down below with the wood trim. All of our window controls are here with the mirrors that do power fold in. Door lock and unlock, we've got the memory seats right there. We've got one of the mirrors, again, has blind spot monitoring. Got the speaker for the Bose sound system. Got a little plaque right there. And then here are the seats at the front. So leather with the perforated leather here in the center. And then the leather for the bolsters and then all down below. Got your power adjustments right there. Pedals just down below. We've got that for the hood latch release. Parking brake, we've got the light control here, fog lights, cargo light, drive line select, and then this is the trailer tow mode with the drive mode select as well. The steering wheel is manually adjustable, and there's one we'll look before we pop in. Here's our steering wheel for this Sierra 1500. First off, got leather all around the steering wheel itself. darker stitching. Then you can see all the trim right here, the GMC logo. Voice command, phone controls, controls for the center stack. Radio controls are on the back of the steering wheel. Got our heated steering wheel button right here. And then this is all for the cruise control system. We have our turn signal slash windshield wiper stock. And that's all for that. We also have the calm shifter with the manual shift function for that 10-speed automatic. And there we go. Here is the center gauge cluster here. Notice that most of it's a bunch of analog gauges. You have the screen there on the center, which you can scroll through a few different menus. So your home, information on the vehicle, music, navigation, phone, and then your settings page right there. And then this is where the trailer tow mode pops up. And then also you have the drive modes, normal, sport, and then off-road that you can scroll between. And that's all for the center. Here's the infotainment system. First off, we're going to pop it into reverse. Accidentally popped it in neutral. There we go. Reverse. Got the trajectory lines right there. You can go to the trailer tow mode and then the zoom in function right there. A really good camera system. Resolution's great, easy to use. And then moving on from that to the rest of the infotainment system, we've got Android Auto and Apple CarPlay that comes with this truck. Response time with the screen is fantastic. And that's all for that. Analog controls here for the infotainment system. And then we've got our analog controls for the climate system. This has dual zone climate, has heated and ventilated seats as well. Notice we have the blink switches on either side, but the rest of it, we've got a bunch of switches. So we've got our lane departure right there, parking sensors, that's for the tailgate to drop it down. We've got this for the hazard lights, stability control, outlets, hill descent control. And then this is like our outlet area right here, because you actually have a full power outlet and then just a bunch of charging ports. We've got our trailer brake controls. We've got right here the wireless phone charger, tons of storage, cup holders. And then notice how we have the center console right here with all the leather and stitching. You can see the storage space here. USBs, auxiliary, all that fun jazz. Really nice. Notice the material use here all over the dash. And then we've got the dual glove box right there. Definitely looks nice. And moving on from that here to the top, we have the sunroof. And then we do have the power setting window. And then notice we have the controls for the sunroof and then the universal garage door opener. And that's all. And then also this just has the traditional mirror. Now there's quite a bit of glare, so it's hard to see the window sticker, but again, 2022 Sierra 1500 Limited SLT, and this one's got quite a few options. So after everything's said and done, total MSRP is $63,955, and wait for it. Let's take it out and see how it drives. So let's talk about visibility before we set off. There's your visibility of the hood, both of the mirrors, the rest of the rear, and let's set off. So we are setting off here in the GMC Sierra 1500 SLT X31, super long name, right? First off, let's talk about the road noise and the ride quality. So from a ride quality perspective, very quiet, road noise is pretty minimal. Of course, gotta punch it. Pretty good from acceleration standpoint as well. Gets up and moves at a really decent pace, so that is solid as well. That 6.2 V8, yeah, it's just so peppy. This truck really is very smooth. I definitely love it from a ride quality perspective. We'll see how turn-in is. Yeah, steering's pretty good. Definitely feels like a half-ton truck. Definitely feel that. Yeah, it drives really good. I just drove an AT4 before this, and you can perceive a slight difference. Like it's very minimal. You've got to really be nitpicking to really feel the difference. This definitely feels lower to the ground than the AT4. You can feel that for sure. But other than that, they're pretty close. So let's sum things up here with this X31 package SLT. First off, exterior wise, I think it's a good looking truck. I love GMC's styling. Interior wise, it's nice. You've got leather upholstery, you've got heated cooled seats, you've got a nice infotainment system. It's just a nice place to be. And then in terms of the driving, it's smooth, it's quiet, it's comfortable. And then also that 6.2 V8 performs very well. So I really don't have anything negative to say about it. So yeah, as an overall package, it's great. And then for a rating, this is kind of like it's not their Denali, right? It's kind of like an entry-level luxury truck. For 63 grand, I think it's a really good value.
And so, yeah, I'd say this is like an 8.5 out of 10. And this doesn't even have the changes that will come with the, redesigned version of the 22 rather. This is just the old version, but it's a 22. It's kind of confusing what they're doing. But yeah, still really solid truck. Now that's going to sum things up for our video on this 2022 GMC Sierra 1500 SLT. Again, a huge shout out and thank you to National GMC here in American Fork for giving me some time with this Sierra. Check out their inventory link below. I'll see all of you in the next video.